Hey, you, I need you to hit the subscribe button below.
Shalom Israel, Captain OC.
Officer Tobias.
And today we back with another 15 minutes with the captains. Today is a very, very important topic. It's a scripture that's very, very misconstrued that a lot of people do not understand. Today's class is titled, Two Gathered in My Name. Because the common misconception in the world of Christianity is as long as two or three people are gathered in the Lord's name, you can have church right there and he's in the midst of us. So let's get the proper understanding on that. Let's go to Psalms 111 and 10 first to show you how you get the understanding of basic scriptures such as this. Read that.
Book of Psalms, chapter 111, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Uh-huh.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. So one thing you'll understand is that the previous understanding of this scripture, it all comes from those in Christianity. And they don't keep no commandments at all. So how can we trust their understanding of the Bible when they do not apply the commandments? So, two or three gathered in my name. A lot of times we hear that, we know on the Christianity side, but even in the truth, brothers and sisters will use that as an excuse not to congregate. Right. Me and my friend together, or me and my wife, my family, God is in the midst of us. Go to Sirach 32 and 17. We're going to show you what you're doing when you make up that excuse and you try to use that scripture to cover up. Read that.
The book of Sirach, chapter 32, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
A sinful man will not be reproved.
A what?
A sinful man will not be reproved.
A sinful man won't take the correct understanding of the Bible. But what they will do?
But findeth an excuse.
But what?
Findeth an excuse.
Uh-huh.
According to his will.
But they find an excuse according to their will. They say, you only need two or three. And God is in the midst of us. We don't have to congregate.
Right.
I don't have to have members of a body and different people from all around. And I've got to travel to go to a school. You ain't got to do all that. Two or three in the Lord's name and we good. Isaiah 28 and 13.
The book of Isaiah chapter 28 verse 13.
Uh-huh.
But the word of the Lord was unto them precept upon precept.
So the word is unto them precept upon precept.
Precept upon precept,
uh-huh.
Line upon line,
uh-huh.
Line upon line,
uh-huh.
Here a little and there a little,
read,
that they might go and fall backward and be broken and snared and taken.
That they may be broken and snared and taken. This is the lot of people on the earth today. They misconstrue scriptures and they can go precept upon precept, line upon line, but it's for them to be broken and snared. So hopefully today, we can show you the proper understanding and you accept it and you repent of your individualized ways. All right. So let's get the scripture that they love to quote. Matthew 18 and 20. Let's read it.
The book of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 20.
Uh-huh.
For where two or three are gathered in my name,
uh-huh,
there I am in the midst of
them.
So
where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them. So they use that to say, I don't have to go to church. I don't have to be in a congregation. All I need is two or three in the Lord, and God is in the midst of us. Okay, so now let's get the proper understanding. Let's start at verse 15. We got to keep it what? In context. Read that.
Matthew chapter 18, verse 15.
Uh-huh.
Moreover, if thy brother shall trespass against thee,
uh-huh,
go and tell him his fault between thee and him alone.
Uh-huh.
If he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother.
So what is this context dealing with? It's dealing with a council. It's a matter. Right. It is a matter that's being discussed right here. Read verse 16.
But if he will not hear thee.
So somebody trespass against somebody else. You go to him. Hey, brother, you sinned against me. He don't agree with you. Okay, what must you do? Read.
Then take with thee one or two more.
Hold on. Take what?
One or two more.
So now you get two witnesses, including yourself. That's your two or three. Read.
That in the mouth of two or three witnesses,
uh-huh,
every word may be established.
So you're getting witnesses, right, so that a matter could be established. Now, is that new? Let's see. Where are they getting this from? Go to Deuteronomy chapter 19 and verse 15. Because remember, this is a council. This is a judgment. This is a matter that's being discussed. And they're telling you how to go about it, how to handle it. And what are they basing it upon? The laws of God. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Read that.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 19, verse 15.
Uh-huh.
One witness shall not rise up against a man for any iniquity.
Read.
Or for any sin.
Or for any sin, right? If your brother trespassed against thee. Read.
In any sin that he sinned at the mouth of two witnesses. Or at the mouth of three witnesses.
At the mouth of two or three witnesses, read.
Shall the matter be established.
You see that? At the mouth of two or three,
right.
Shall the matter be established. Not at the mouth of two or three, you can have church.
Right.
Read. Keep reading that.
If a false witness rise up against any man to testify against him,
uh-huh.
that which is wrong.
Read.
Then both the men between whom the controversy is. Shall stand before the Lord,
uh-huh.
before the priests,
uh-huh.
and the judges, which shall be in those days.
So, they're going to stand before all the leadership. Keep reading.
And the judges shall make diligent inquisition.
Uh-huh.
And behold, if the witness be a false witness and have testified falsely against his brother.
So, the key part was they will make a diligent inquisition at the mouth of what? Two or three witnesses.
Right.
Now, this matter, this cause, this counsel can be established properly. Go back to Matthew 18, and now let's read verse 17 down.
Book of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
And if he shall neglect to hear them.
So now you told it to the two or three witnesses. He still ain't hearing what he did was wrong. Read.
Tell it unto the church.
Uh-huh. The church was what? The leadership, the right. judges, and the priest.
Right.
Read.
But if he neglect to hear the church,
uh-huh.
let him be unto thee as a heathen man and a publican.
Throw him out on his head. Put him from amongst the congregation. If he don't agree with what? The judgment. This right. whole context is taking place with what? Judgment. It's not talking about a church service. Read.
Verily I say unto you, whosoever ye shall bind on earth
uh-huh.
shall be bound in heaven.
Whatever judgment is made, because remember, the judgment is not man's. Right. We're going to read that. Whatever judgment we make on earth is bound in heaven. Read.
And whatsoever ye shall loose on earth
uh-huh.
shall be loosed in heaven.
When you forgive a man, it's Christ forgive him. Read.
Again, I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on
that
earth.
That if two of you shall agree on earth. On what? On the judgment.
Right.
Read.
As touching anything that they shall ask. It shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven.
Right, because he's in agreement with the judgment that is made. Read.
For where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them.
Right, wherever judgment is made, the Most High God is in the midst of them. Why? Because the judgment is God's. Let's read it. Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 17. This is simple, but modern day Christianity has misconstrued the scriptures so much that our people are brain dead. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
Ye shall not respect persons in judgment.
Ye shall what?
Not respect persons in judgment.
And that's another scripture as well people don't understand. Respect of persons. Respect. It's talking about in judgment.
Right.
The Bible always had respect for people. He got respect unto the nation of Israel.
Right.
He had respect unto his priests. The Bible says, know them which labor among you. When it's talking about respect of persons, it's talking about in judgment. Read.
But ye shall hear the small as well as the great.
Uh-huh.
Ye shall not be afraid of the face of man.
Ye shall not be afraid of the face of man. Read.
For the judgment is God.
Hold on. Read that again.
For the judgment is God.
The judgment is God's. That's why he say at the mouth of two or three, there I am in the midst of them. Why? Because it's God that's bringing down the judgment among the people. It's not those men, but you're not spiritual. You don't understand that. Read that scripture all over again.
Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
Ye shall not respect persons in judgment.
Read.
But ye shall hear the small as well as the great.
Read.
Ye shall not be afraid of the face of man, for the judgment is God's.
Uh-huh.
And the cause that is too hard for you, bring it unto me, and I will hear it.
And I will hear. Go to Deuteronomy 17. Let's get another precept. Just to back it up, so you don't think we just read in one place. 17, start at verse 5.
Deuteronomy chapter 17, verse 5.
Is that what I want? Let me see. Deuteronomy 17, 5. Yep.
Then shalt thou bring forth that man or that woman
uh-huh.
which have committed that wicked thing unto thy gate, even that man or that woman, and shalt stone them with stones till thy die.
Read.
at the mouth of two witnesses or three witnesses, shall he that is worthy of death be put to death.
Read.
But at the mouth of one witness, he shall not be put to death.
Right. That's why it says what? In the midst of two or three. Right. There I am in the midst of them. In judgment. You can't pass judgment unless you got two or three. Right. Read.
At the mouth of two or three witnesses, shall he that is worthy of death be put to death.
Uh-huh.
But at the mouth of one witness, he shall not be put to death.
But at the mouth of one witness shall he not be put to death. So, let's prove to you what a convocation is. Because a lot of people think that two or three is a convocation. That's not right. Now, I'm not saying if you're in the middle of nowhere by yourself, right. We understand that. But if you're somewhere where other Israelites are and you're refusing to congregate and come amongst them, you're not keeping the Sabbath day correctly. You're not keeping the Passover correctly. You're not keeping Pentecost correctly. You're not keeping the new moon correctly. You're being an individualite. You're not keeping the commandments, and you're not saved by Matthew 18 and 20. No, that's not what that's talking about. Read Joel 1 and 14.
The book of Joel, chapter 1, verse 14.
Uh-huh.
Sanctify ye a fast.
Uh-huh.
Call a solemn assembly.
Uh-huh.
Gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land.
Hold on, gather what?
The elders and all the inhabitants of the land.
Gather all the inhabitants of the land together. Why didn't they say, hey, it's a solemn assembly. You got two? Are you good?
Right.
You got three? Are you good? No. He said, gather all the inhabitants. Now, we're not saying bring anybody in your house. Bring those that keep the commandments in the faith of Christ. Those that you know to keep the commandments. That's who you're supposed to be around. But it's not two or three people. Read that scripture again.
Sanctify ye a fast. Call a solemn assembly.
Uh-huh.
Gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land into the house of the Lord your God.
Mm-hmm.
And cry unto the Lord.
And cry unto the Lord. Go to Tobit real quick. Let's back that up in the book of Tobit. Go to Tobit chapter 2 and start at verse 1. We're going to show you. Even Tobit knew. Tobit had a family in his house. Right. He didn't say, hey, it's me, you, and our son. We good. Let's see what Tobit did.
The book of Tobit, chapter 2, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Now when I was come home again, and my wife Anna was restored unto me with my son Tobias in the feast of Pentecost.
In the feast of Pentecost, a high holy day, read.
Which is the holy feast of the 7 weeks.
Uh-huh.
There was a good dinner prepared me, in the which I sat down to eat.
Read.
And when I saw abundance of meat, I said to my son, go and bring what poor man soever thou shalt find out of our brethren.
Go find whoever you can find of my brethren. Read.
Who is mindful of the Lord.
Who is what?
Who is mindful of the Lord.
Go find anybody out there to keep the commandments and tell them to come here.
Right.
Why? Because he understood that to really keep the feast, you got to have other brothers and sisters around you. Right. You got to have the spirit of Christ. Christ went and dwelt with the people. He fed 5,000 at one time.
Right.
He never had the understanding that it's me, Peter, and John, one of the disciples, and we good.
Right.
No, we waking up a nation. All of you that got that mindset, two or three, individualite, y'all against the gathering together of the nation of Israel. You got to understand that. From there, go to 1 Samuel 20 and verse 24. 1 Samuel 20 and verse 24. Give you another example of a feast day with our forefathers wondering why people ain't there. Why we ain't gathering together. Read that.
Book of 1 Samuel chapter 20 verse 24.
Uh-huh.
So David hid himself in the field. And when the new moon was come, the king sat down to eat meat.
Mm-hmm.
And the king sat upon his seat as at other times, even upon a seat by the wall.
Read.
And Jonathan arose. And Abner sat by Saul's side, and David's place was empty.
So on the feast day, David had a spot where he always sat.
Right.
Meaning what? They kept it together. They congregated. Read.
Nevertheless, Saul spake not anything that day, for he thought something had befallen him. He is not clean. Surely he is not clean.
So they thought something had to be wrong with David for him not to appear before the feast. Because we always kept it with the same mindset, which is what? Everybody come together on these days of gladness. Last scripture, Exodus chapter 23 and verse 2. So we pray you get in the Leviticus 23. So we pray and you get an understanding of what it means when it says two or three are gathered in his name. And you understand the importance and how to properly congregate. Read that.
The book of Leviticus chapter 23 Verse 2.
Uh-huh.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Read.
And say unto them, concerning the feast of the Lord,
uh-huh,
which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocation.
Holy what?
Holy convocation.
Uh-huh.
Even these are my feasts.
So the days of the Lord are holy convocations,
right,
not holy separations. Our people want to have holy separations with one brother or one sister. Y'all got to understand what is required of the Lord. The Lord is raising up the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, a nation, not just one family. All right, with that, we say shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.